Good morning, children. Now, next one is we have done already the energy of energy stored in a capacitor and what are the equivalent capacitors for series and parallel combination. I hope you can remember that. Okay. Now, what will be the energy stored in combination of capacitor? Now, here you see. Instead of one capacitor, if you take several charge capacitor and if you join them together, then what will be the total energy stored? That you will find out. Alright. So, first one I have taken energy stored for series combination. Alright. Now, for series combination, we know that charge is same for all the capacitors. Now, remember that what is the expression for energy? This one you don't have to write. I am just telling you for your better understanding. What is the energy stored in the capacitor? One can write this formula, Q square by 2C, or you can write half CV square. Okay. Now, when it is series combination, then as Q is same for all, so for series combination, we will consider this expression for the means expression for the energy stored in each capacitor. Okay. Now, in series combination, what will be the energy stored in the combination? You can write it as Q square divided by 2C, where C is the equivalent capacitance. Alright. Now, you know that whenever the capacitances are connected in series, then equivalent capacitance 1 by C, you can write it as 1 by C1, 1 by C2, so on. Suppose we are having n number of capacitances. You can write this. So you see, you can separate the terms now. Q square by 2C1, then it will be Q square by 2C2, so on. And last term is Q square by 2CN. So, what is this? It is charge of the first capacitor, U1. What is this? Charge of the second capacitor, U2 and UN. So, what is the energy stored in a combination? It is nothing but the sum of the energy stored in each capacitor. Alright? So, this is the concept you have to apply. Then, next one is, instead of series combination, if you take parallel combination, then in parallel combination, which expression for energy we will use? Half CV square. Why not Q square by 2C? Why half CV square? Because for parallel combination, V is same for all. Okay, Q is not same for all. So, we will not consider this expression for parallel combination. We will consider this expression for parallel combination. So, this first point, if you fail to remember, then you won't be able to prove it. So, this is the first point you have to always remember. We should consider that expression for which one quantity, leaving the capacitance, remains same for all. Okay, so for parallel combination, as V is same for all, so what is the expression we use? Half CV square. Now, you know for parallel combination, C is equal to C1 plus C2 plus Cn if there are n number of capacitance. So, again, you just separate the terms. So, you can write it as half C1V square. Then next one, you can write it as half C2V square. Then what will be the last term? It will be half CnV square. Now, half C1V square, what is this? Energy of the first capacitor. Then this one, energy of the second capacitor. So, you see, what is the ultimate result we have got? That is most important. That it does not matter how you are joining the capacitor. You may join the capacitor in series, you may join the capacitor in parallel, but in both the cases, what will be the energy of the combination? It will be sum of individual energy of all capacitors connected. Alright, so you must learn this concept. This derivation generally do not come, but you should remember the concept you have got.